Hello and good evening. It is good evening now, isn't it? And it's the launch of the brand new One Day Special. You are going to absolutely love this One Day Special. It's by Sue. We've got Sue Smith in the studio, other end of the studio, I must say. Do you want to give us a little wave, Sue? There we go. We're just going to cut to Sue so you can see Sue. Here she is, giving us a little wave. There we go. Oh, she's at the top. I was waiting for, I was thinking I was going to see her full screen. Right, there she is in the little box, bless her. Right, Sue, actually, now I know we've been emailing, haven't we, about sort of how you got to collaborate with Els, but seeing as I've got you here in the studio, do you want to tell the story?
Yeah. Well, the collaboration story.
Indeed, yes.
Well, being a sort of demonstrator and I do lots of commissions with crafting. I don't really tend to buy many products myself, but as soon as I saw the planner range, the first planner range that Elizabeth bought to us, I thought, wow, I have to buy that. I absolutely loved it. So I did and started crafting with it. And then I uploaded what I was doing on her Facebook page and she quite liked what I was doing. And then the second range, she actually wanted to borrow my planner as a sample. So she did that, and then when she returned it to me, she found out that I did the hand lettering and liked what I was doing. So she's given me this lovely opportunity, which I'm so grateful for.
Yay, that's so nice. I love it, I love it. So do you want to actually talk us through what we've got in the One Day Special?
Yes, we've got I can't see what you're...
Oh, bless you.
What you're looking at, but they're basically five sets.
Yeah.
And they kind of each set incorporates a large scale caption that you can use as it is, basically good for cards and planner pages. Mm-hmm. And then there's some other captions that for different shaped areas.
Yeah.
And then there's also like a verse caption that you can use for a verse. And then there's these little doodle images that you can have fun with, incorporate them in the design, colour them in, and just have fun with it, really, and get creative.
Absolutely. So we're having a nice little pan down of these gorgeous... I mean, your hand lettering is just absolutely divine. Look at this. They're beautiful. I just love your font. Everything about it is stunning. And now we have got... some wonderful samples to show you as well. It's already getting very, very busy out there, but you've got the Have the Best Day Today Celebrate. You do have some extras on there. You can see there's a little champagne glass, a heart. Oh, there's bunting. That's very apt for today, isn't it? Being VE Day. So look there, we've got the Big Dream. Happy birthday to you. You've got some extras with the letters. Now, they are all available individually, but obviously the saving is with the One Day Special. Must just say that it's going to be dispatched from the 16th of May, so not too long to wait. And we're having a look at a few samples here, and I've got quite a few behind. So check these out. Look at these, the beautiful, oh yeah, this is the Dream Big, is absolutely stunning. How nice for home decor, definitely, as well as, you know, your card making. Here's the birthday wishes. Now they emboss like a dream, don't they? Oh, what about this one? We've got happy birthday to you on this one. Again, now you're going to use these time and time again, obviously in your planners and your journals as well. So I will show you a few more samples and then we'll get cracking with Sue's demonstrations. Hang on, I'm just picking up a few more for you to show. Wonderful. Look at that. And that's so nice. That's all you need, isn't it? That's a real nice focal point. Bit of an inky background going on. And what about onto your tags? Which is marvellous. There you go. So I'll show you loads more samples throughout the course of this hour and obviously the 8 o'clock hour. But I know you're eager to see the demonstrations. You can spread the cost, two payments of £29.48. 332875 is the item number. Getting super busy out there. Yep. Right. So without further ado, I'm going to hand you over to Sue.
Thank you. Hello. Right, I've got the stamp sets here and I'll just quickly show you what they're like stamped out. So we've got the birthday, the just for you, the your day, celebrate and the hello set. And let's start off with a VE Day themed card, shall we? So this one, the celebrate one, is good for that. So we'll use that one and I might incorporate some stars as well. So we'll get those away. The stars are that one. So start with these ones. So I'll bring in my stamping platform, and I've got a smooth, super smooth A4 sized piece of paper there, and we'll grab the caption, "Today is the day," because it is. Put it about there in the middle. And I've got my VersaMark, the archival ink in black. There. And it's not the juiciest ink, that's why I'm using my stamping platform. Right. So I've done that the once, and I'm going to use the second generation as well, stamping, and I'm just going to move that very slightly just so I can incorporate a second generation there, just to give it like a shadow line. There, can you see that? Gives it like a shadow line. And it brings the caption to life, really. So it gives it sort of, lifts it off the page slightly and makes it look a bit different. So that's easily achievable. And then I'm going to add some bunting. So I'll move that and grab the bunting. I'm going to have that going about there. And I'd like to extend the bunting, so I need to not ink up the little bows at the either end. So I've got a mask here that I'm going to put on so I can ink the bunting and not incorporate the bows. So I want to extend it. And then I can reposition this about there. And then do the same thing, mask off the little bows. So you can make your bunting as long as you like to fit any space. Okay. And then also I'd like to do another row here and overlap this piece of bunting. So to make it look like it's going behind, I'm just going to ink this up, masking the bows again at each end, so I just get the triangles. And I've cut out a section of the bunting. I've just stamped it basically and cut it out, just so I can place it over and mask that one, so that it stamps not on top of it directly and it looks like it's sitting behind. Oh, that piece didn't come out, did it? There. So basically you get a nice, need to do that one again. That one didn't come out. So basically you get two nice strings of bunting. So I'll just do this one as well. Just gives you the idea. Okay. I've got one that I've done as well where I've completed all the bunting here. And now let's incorporate some of the little doodle designs. So I like the confetti one. So we'll give some of that, and there's several different sizes as well. So the confetti looks like it's sort of floating in the air, some forward and some further back. Have some streamers, and I do like these, the stars in this other set as well. So the beauty about the stamping platform is that you can pick up more than one, ink them all up. So basically I'm just filling the card with all these designs. Place them wherever you think they look nice. And the beauty of these is I think they do look nice as they are, but incorporate some colour and have some fun introducing colour to your designs as well. I'm just cleaning the ink off the stamp before I replace these, because if I wanted to move it, then I'd leave like a little bit of secondary ink behind. So I have another star down there. And maybe some more confetti up there. I mean, if you're sort of shy about stamping, then I recommend a platform. It really transforms your stamping, I think. There. Right, so that's enough of the design done. And I'm going to use one of the fitted frames. I rather like this one with the notched corners. I'm going to use the biggest one. So I'm going to cut this out on my design, probably about there. And die cut that out. And for speed, I've die cut one out already. And then what I'm going to do as well is I'm going to cut out each bunting with my craft knife, just so that you can lift it up. Just so you can lift it up and bend it, and it makes it look like real bunting. There. So I'm going to do, I think I might have, yeah, I've done all of those. And then we can add some colour. Let's get patriotic. So alcohol markers are really good to use, and watercolours, even pencil crayons. Add some blue as well. There we go. And also I'm going to add some colour to the little doodles as well.
Now, just while you're colouring in there, Sue, I need to let you know that 10% of the stock has already gone in 10 minutes.
Wow,
that's fabulous.
Oh, thank you for purchasing them. That's lovely.
Absolutely. And also, don't forget, we've still got the event running this whole weekend where you can get 4 for 3. There's the quote. It's VE 4 for 3 at the bottom of the screen. And you'll literally get four things. Hang on. Now, which way around? I always say this the wrong way. You get 4 things for the price of 3. Pretty much. Basically, the lowest price item you'll get for free. That's what it is. You just got to quote the code. I always get myself muddled up with that. So, Sue, is your street doing any social distancing party today?
Yes, they're all out there with their chairs. Actually, I live in the bottom of a cul-de-sac, so they're all in front of the house in their, you know, family groups with their chairs at 3 o'clock.
Oh, nice.
Having a nice gathering and glass of wine in the sun. But I was getting ready, so I couldn't join them. And then I had to make the move to get the car out.
Oh, bless.
Oh. Right then. So does that look patriotic enough? Yes, I think so. So I'm just going to tease the bunting flags out. Just curl them with my fingers. Just it gives it a bit of extra depth and interest. And then we can use the other notched. No, I can't, because they're smaller. I'll have to cut myself a bigger piece of paper because I've used the biggest one. So I just wanted to match this up just to make it look nice. So I'll add some glue. And missing the flags, of course, because we want them raised. So add this to this piece of red textured card. I've flattened them now, haven't I? And then I'll mat that onto white. Like that. I like cards with lots of layers, matted layers. It makes them look really cheerful and makes the design stand out. And then we have, of course, a lovely blue matted layer, which actually is my card blank. So I've used this textured card to cut a square card blank. top fold. So I can add this to it. And then of course we can add a little verse inside as well. So here we've got the celebrate stamp. And I've just added another little doodle and coloured that in to sort of keep the theme going inside the card. There. Thank you.
Thank you, Sue. I'm going to do a quick recap then while you get set for the next demonstration. So as we were saying, this is super busy at the moment. It's a beautiful collection, hand-lettered, hand-drawn by Sue's fair hand. You've got 54 stamps in total here. They are just beautiful, got all sorts of different occasions. You've got your day for you. There's a hello, a celebrate and a birthday collection. All sorts of nice different sizes on there. And you've got some extras you'll see. So let's have a look at this one. Be brave, do good, stay you. That's really nice, isn't it? And then you've got the smaller happy, but then the big birthday. I like that different, I like mixing and matching like the size of the fonts. Positive vibes, that's definitely what we all need at the moment. And you've got a few birthday candles there, a few swirls. And then we can come to the celebrate. We've got have the best day today. There's a popping cork. Then you've got the celebrate. And there's a little glass of bubbly. And then there's some extras like streamers and things with the hearts. And today is the day. And then the bunting, which is awesome. Perfect. It couldn't be more perfect for today, could it? And then we come to another set. There we go. Again, beautiful. You got this. I like that. Beautifully drawn and written. And of course, you can be using your planners and your journals. You can use these for your cards, for home decor even. I like the dream big. And we've got more. There's the one at the top. Just for you. Wish big. That's another really nice one. Again, you've got some little presents, little workers. Do we need to pick this up? Yeah, there you go. You've got birthday happiness. That's lovely. And then here's one. I'll have to pick this up a little bit. There you are, so you can see the bottom. Oh, a nice little cupcake. Oh, there's a bit of birthday cake there. Your day, your way. Very nice. And then let's show some more samples. So this one, using some of the little extras that we've got with them. Love those little cups. And then we've got the celebrate, all those popping corks. That makes a really good background, doesn't it? And then we've got our birthday wishes. Lovely. So either you can have it as a focal point or it's just a little extra. Maybe just do a nice splashy background. Even you could do bookmarks if you wanted. I like that in the rainbow colours. Very nice. And then we've got just for you. Oh, I love that, so pretty. Now I've got here, hang on, we've got the journal here. Let's take a sneak peek of what's inside. This is, Els, remember? So you can see, look, today is the day. Hello. Gorgeous, look at these. They're just wonderful. Like that with the emboss. Positive vibes only, I agree. That's fabulous, isn't it? Oh, I like that. It's done a little bit differently. Amazing. There we go. Oh, somebody's birthday. There you go. Right, you can spread the cost on FlexiBuy for all of these stamps. You're getting 54 in total. Two payments of £29.48. 332875 is the item number. Next up then, we have got some of the wonderful essential nesting dies. You've got four options here. So then So we've got your four options. These two come together. We'll get the names because these have got the wonderful like little indented edges. This is the indented fitted rectangle and square. I like the indent. I think it looks really posh actually. So you've got all of those dies. It comes with this with the squares as well. And I've got a little sample behind here just to show you. I've got a couple actually. Again, using the One Day Special, but it just looks really effective with the indent. There we go. Marvellous. So that is £18.98. And there's a £9 saving. And then we've got this next one. This one's our stitched detail. It's sort of the rounded fitted, if you will. Yeah, that's what you've got there. Shall I turn it around again, just so you can see? Well, this one also has like that nice stitch detail. Really like that. Okay. And then you've got your rounded edges there. Marvellous. And then have we got one more? Still going? Yep. Here we are, these two, where they've got a stitch detail and we called it rounded stitch. That's that one. Okay, lovely. So you can choose your two, whichever two you want. For £18.98, £9 saving, 679603. Have a look on the website to see which set you'd like. Then we go on to, these are the fishtails. We've got these. Again, brilliant for your planners and your journals. I think, see, look at that sample. That looks excellent. That looks really effective in all of those rainbow colours. If you'd like to go for these, it's £10.99 and you get 5 dies. I like the way that's been matted and layered in the colours. It's gorgeous, isn't it? 527045 is your item number. Then we've also got some fishtails, but this time, again, you've got like a nice stitched detail to them. Would I say stitched? It's almost, yeah, it is. It is. There you go. And for this set, £10.99. Item number is 546514. Do give us a call, 01733 60 2000, or of course you can check out on the website at hachanda.com, where you'll find even more. We've got some ovals. These also come in a pair. Very nice, with the stitched and dot details in that one. And then this one, just the simple cut. Our Jimmy's just said, the packaging's so nice. I agree. And what you get is nice too. £21.99, £8 saving, 036658. And then we've also got some circles. Again, you're getting that, the one of them that's the plain version, and the other one that's got that sort of stitched and dots that you can see. Just a nice little extra feature. £21.99, 090321. Here's the website so you can check out the gorgeous one day special. And just while you're perusing and checking out, we're going to sort the cameras out so we can go back to our lovely Sue for the next part, the next demonstration. Also, if you'd like to become a Freedom member, nice and easy, 888888 is the item number. And you can set yourself up. You ready to go, Sue? She's nodding at me. Here we go, we're passing back to Sue.
Hello. Okay, I feel a rainbow theme coming on now. So I'm going to use this big Your Day, Your Way caption, because I love the fact that it is nice and large and it'll give definitely an impact on a card. So you can just use this and just create a nice background. So let's go for a rainbow. Right, no, I'm going to do it on my mat. Okay, I've got a craft mat here and I'm just going to put my ink down on here because I want to add water rather than put it on the paper, which I did, which was a mistake. So we'll put it on the craft mat and then spritz it with water. Quite a bit of water. That should do it. And then we're going to sort of place our card down and just drag it sideways to incorporate that lovely rainbow ink there, which is lovely. And I'm going to give it another little spray with a finer spray and give it some heat just to dry. Just take that away there. And then also, which is a nice effect, if you get a brush and you can add some splashes, bigger splashes like that, and that'll create some nice interesting effects. Especially when you heat the heat gun, the ink, the water sort of moves around And then it creates these lovely paler areas. There, you don't want to watch me dry that. So I have got one very similar that I did earlier. And I can take this away as well. And bringing my stamping platform. That's it. So we can add our caption. So put that about there. So I'm going to ink this up with some black archival ink as well. So that will really pop on this lovely rainbow colour. So I need to do it a couple of times because my ink pad is wearing out. That's it, push it down. Maybe just one more. I like to get a nice strong image. That'll be all right. So I think that's just lovely as it is. I don't think I need to use any of the sort of doodle designs or anything. I'm just going to give that a quick blast just to dry that black ink. And then I'm going to place that on just a plain white card blank. That's it. If I cut off one of the edges, I think I need to do it about there. Don't measure anything, just do it by eye. And then about there as well. And then what you can do is you can offer it up to the card blank. This is how I trim things, and then just make a notch where I'd like it to go that way and that way. And then I can use the grid lines of my mat, because I don't actually have a guillotine. I kind of do it this way. So I can get it square. Don't throw that bit away, that can be useful for something else. And then again, I'll just trim the bottom. Hopefully that'll fit nicely on our card. Okay, yes, I think that's nice. So I'll just attach this. I do love a glue stick, I must admit. That's it. Place that on there. And another little detail that you could do with your lettering is if you've got a white gel pen or a paint pen, you can add some highlights. And I've got a white paint pen here. So I'm just going to just add some flecks. I might have to, that's it, get this pen working. And the ink's probably needs to dry a little bit more. It's not really showing up. Soaking into the ink too much, I think. So you can just do a little flick of highlight just on the top of all the thicker strokes. That's better. My pen working. And it just makes it pop even more. So you can add lots of details and make the lettering your own. There. So that's pretty much it for that one. And then here I've done something similar using sort of just one ink, using it for the background and then stamping it a few times to get that depth of colour in the caption. And I'll put that on craft card. And then also, can I quickly show you this? This is a planner page that I wanted to do with the lovely rainbow as well. So I've made this pretty much the same way. And then I'm going to incorporate some designs from the nesting dies. These are such a great staple thing to have in your craft stash, I think, all of these nesting dies. So if you place them all together with some craft tape and run that through your die cutting machine with your card, then you end up getting a load of frames.
Sue, just a quick question. Which particular frames were you using there? Which nested dies?
This is the fitted squares.
Excellent. Thank you. It's got the rounded edge, hasn't it?
Yes, yeah, the fitted squares.
Thanks, Sue.
Yeah. So I've now got some lovely black frames that I can incorporate on my planner page to go with that lettering. And then I think I'll just use these smaller ones to actually insert some photos later. So it's just to show you that, you know, you can use these captions on your in your planners as well. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Sue. We're going to do another quick recap then. And again, I'll show you lots more samples that we've got. Now, we're nearly 20% gone of the one-day special. They're hand-lettered stamps by Sue's Fair Hand. They are beautiful for you to use. You could either, you know, use them as a, I'm just having a little look here, you could have a large caption as a focal point, or a complementary caption as a verse inside a card, a caption for an alternative shaped space. You could use a caption as an inspirational sentiment, great for artwork and great for your planner pages. You could use it repeatedly for backgrounds, a few doodle images as well for inspiration to use with the captions. That's what you've got in your one day special. So you've got celebrate, you've got something for all occasions really. Have the best day, there's that popping cork, love that one. And then we're just taking a nice look in detail at all of those lovely sentiments and words and the font that Sue has created. Dream big, happy birthday. Oh, that's it, happy birthday to you. Marvellous. I've got some samples. Let's show you here. This is lovely. This you've got the hello again as a focal point. A bit of gel pen's been used and a little bit of shadowing behind, a little bit of shading, which is lovely. I'll start mentioning who's been doing these actually. This one is by Jackie. That's nice because it's like a nice inky effect. This one here is another one by Jackie. Hello from me to you. Perfect. There's loads of rainbow colour themes, isn't there? That again is by Jackie. And then we've got one here. Beautiful. This one, onto some vellum, which is gorgeous. I like that. Have the best day today. Positive vibes only, definitely. And there we go. We've got that lovely rainbow. Stunning. This one's by Janet. Nice. I really like the different compartments. Ah, yes, and then the sentiment inside. That worked, that's really effective. And lovely, this is another one by Janet. Gorgeous with the silver emboss. I think that works really, really nicely. Oh, we've got one that's a little bit Art Deco coming up. That is also by Janet, lovely. And again, throughout the course of the evening and tomorrow, we'll show you oodles of samples. £58.95, you've got a £21 saving. And you've also got this on FlexiBuy, two payments of £29.48. Then we've got our nested rectangle and square dies. I think we might have had them a little bit mixed earlier, so we're just going to clarify this. These are the configurations. This is the indented fitted. You're getting the square and the rectangles. And I'll turn that one around so you can see. I really like it. It just makes it look a little bit more posh. Almost with the indent. That's one option. The next one is indented stitched. So if you like the indent but you want a little bit more detail, then that's got that in. So you get the squares and again you're getting the rectangles. Next up then we've got the rounded fitted. And this is the one that Sue was using just at the end of the demo there. Bring this in. And then the last one is the rounded stitched. Let's bring this for you to see. And then turn it around. I do, yes, I do very much like the packaging. Each option is £18.98. That is a £9 saving. So those all the pairs that you can go for. 679603 is the item number. Then the next set that we've got is the fishtails. So this one, that's your sort of, shall I say, like it doesn't have the stitch detail, this one. Here you go, so that's that first one. £10.99, that's a lovely sample, isn't it? 527045. Then this one has the stitch detail that I've got here. Marvellous, if I turn it around. Oh yes, you can see it. So it is, isn't it? Yes, at the bottom of this one. I was got confused then. There you go. So you can see that detail there. £10.99, again you get five dies. 546514. Next then, we go for a couple more. These are more options, okay. This is the fitted indented rectangles. Easy for me to say. Nice, so that one's your indented, and then this one has the indent and that stitch detail. And this is £18.98, 657716 is your item number. We do have another couple of options on the show. So same in the squares, and then we've got the rounded. They're there for you at £18.98. We just couldn't fit them all out onto the counter. And then we come back to our ovals. You've got the plain and then the stitched as a collection. And that's £21.99, £8 saving, 12 dies in total. 036658. Oh, there is a sample actually, you're right. Let me show you this. That's by Jackie. That looks really nice, doesn't it? So you can see the difference. Oh, and this is by Sue herself. Lovely. So details are on screen, and then we have another collection. This time it's the circles. One's with the stitched and one is not. And then again, I've got some samples. This one's by Jackie. And then we've got this one again by Jackie. That's clever, isn't it? I like that pocket, nice little trouser pocket. And then this is by Sue. Sue's done this one with the bunting. Today is the day. £21.99, 090321. We've got Leonie just going to tell you, in case you're new to us here at her channel, and thinking, oh, I'd like to get into a bit of crafting and stuff. Well, we've got something called Flexi Order, and here's Leonie to tell you more.
Flexi Order has arrived at her channel. What is Flexi Order? When you place an item on Flexibuy in your basket, you qualify for Flexi Order, which means any other items you add to your basket will also be included in your Flexibuy payments, so you can spread the cost over multiple monthly payments. After your first payment is made, your entire order will be dispatched. When you add at least £60 worth of any items to your shopping basket, either online or on the phone, you'll qualify for our Flexi Order offer. This means you can spread the cost of your order over equal monthly Flexibuy payments, offering you the extra flexibility when you shop with us. Flexi Order, making your shopping experience with Achanda easier.
Marvellous. Right, we're going to go back to Sue for another demo. Here she is.
Thank you. Can I just say a big thank you to Jackie Jasper, who's my design team member, who's produced many of the cards that you can see. And also Janet's actually my mum, so she made a few as well. So thank you. Okay, so this time we're going to go for a little girly birthday card and use this birthday caption here, because I like the thickness of that one with some of these doodle designs as well. So I'm going to get this birthday one. And instead of using the black ink on the birthday, we're going to actually draw on the birthday. I've just got here a water-based brush pen. So I'm just going to just colour, go over the birthday with the water-based ink and just stamp using this. to just give a nice watery effect. That's it, make sure you get it all covered. And then I'm going to spritz this with water, very lightly, not on top of my card. There. And then I'm just going to drop this on my card. Oh, it's bled a little bit. So all I'm going to do is just tap it lightly just to get that ink to move underneath. And then just lift that off and you get like a birthday impression, a nice sort of watery one. But I have just dribbled it there. Wonder if I can remove that just by adding water. No, I can't because it's soaked into the paper. Never mind, I can always do it again. So I'll put that to one side while that's drying. And then I just want to give you, just want to talk about these nesting dies because I'm going to use them for this card. So I'm going to use the rectangles. So I've got here the fitted smooth edged ones and then the stitched ones. So it is useful to have both of these sets actually, because I'm going to use the stitched ones because I like the stitched detail just to add a bit of texture to my card. And then I just want to just quickly show you how they incorporate and relate to each other. So the stitched frame is just that little bit bigger than the smooth cut one. So if you see that. And then they kind of all sit inside each other. So they are, but they are both slightly different sizes. So you don't think that this one's exactly the same size as this one. They are slightly different and they layer up closer together. I hope that makes sense. So then that one's going to sit inside it of that one, and then another smooth one can go around the outside of that. So you just get that more, those more layers. And that applies to every size as well. Okay, so I'm going to cut the medium size out of smooth white card, the same card that I used to stamp the birthday. I'll bring in my platform again, because I want to incorporate some of the doodle designs. And I'm going to use the teacup this time. So I'm going to place the teacup on here, about there. And I only actually want the saucer. So I'm going to mask off the bottom of the cup, get my black archival ink again, and just ink up the saucer. Like that. And then that's going to be my plate so that I can add the cupcake to, because the cupcake's just on its own and I wanted it to sit on a plate. So I've nicked the saucer from the cup and saucer. Okay, so I can ink all my cupcake up. There. It looks nicer on a plate, doesn't it? And then I'm going to grab the smallest little heart here. So we've got some hearts that are hollow and some hearts that are filled in. So I'm going to use this little one just to create some random hearts all over this piece of card and off the card as well. So just go random in all areas. Probably leave this free, just over this side. That's it. When you feel you've got enough, maybe another one there. Okay, and then I'm going to add a bit of colour to my cake. And I'll use my stamping block just to add a bit of colour onto there and pick up the colour with my brush and water. So just add some strong colour to the side of the cupcake here. I should be doing it this way up, shouldn't I? And a bit of colour to the cherry. That's it, just blend that out with my water, just to make it look yummy and girly. I think that's enough. I might be tempted to do the plate, but I think that'll do. I don't want to overdo it. Okay, and then I'll bring my birthday back in. Pretend that mark's not there. And in some of the places where it has got a bit blotchy, you can actually, if you want to, just go back in with the brush and the ink that I put on my stamping block. That's it, just to define it a bit more. But have an experiment, some turn out a bit better than others. Okay, and then I'm going to use the same stamp on top of there, just so I can get the happy and the to you. Oh, take my cake away. Okay. So I need to mask some of the birthday so that I can just get these delicate words. It's that one. They go there. And just get these two words inked up. So just dab it with your finger if you've gone on to the birthday word. I think that looks okay. Just need to, happy's good. The to you just needs a little bit more inking. So you can get quite creative with these stamps and do various different things and colours with them. Okay, now I'm going to die cut this piece using, I've used a medium one, and I've got a smaller one and the larger one. So I'm going to die cut this using the smaller one, and I'm going to actually die cut it from this side and tape it down. It's the end of my tape. And then just run it through half or two-thirds of the way through your machine and then reverse it and bring it back out again, because I actually want to make this rectangle longer. So paste it there, that's it, run it through your machine and cut about there and then reverse back again, and then you'll get like a flap, and then move this along, tape it down, and then do it from the other direction, so you get a longer rectangle. And here's a good one that I did earlier. So my birthday's come out a lot better on this one, hasn't it? Okay, let's make up the card. And then I've got a folded piece of card here that I've actually turned into a card blank by die cutting the larger stitched rectangle. And then to do this, if you just place it so that you don't cut the side edge, so you put your fold just shy of that edge, and then when you run that through, you've still got it incorporates the fold, it doesn't cut the fold, so you can make card blanks out of all these nesting dies as well. Okay, so I'm going to take this piece here. Oh, and another thing is that sometimes the back gets a bit sort of dented with all the scratches and little dents in your plate, so I've actually cut another one so I can use that as the back and it's nice inside, and then I've got this one to place over the top just so it all looks nice and neat. And it also adds strength as well to the card blank, so I'm going to add this to there. And then I've done this one a longer rectangle because I want to fold back this end. So I'm just going to score this end. That's it, and fold it back. I'm going to make a flap out of it. Make sure that's really pressed. Put some glue on the flap. Too much there. And then I'm going to wrap this round there. Actually, I've glued the... Put the glue on the wrong side of the flap. Put it on the inside. There. So it hides the cake. That's it. And then we're going to put some foam pads on that just to lift it. Just to give it some dimension. There. Take off my tape. That's it. And then place that maybe slightly over there just to create the sort of same angles. There. So there's the card. And here's one, another one that I've made earlier, just to show you that I've done a stamping verse inside. So I've incorporated this caption here, this one here, and just left off the today. So I've just got "Have the best day" and added another little heart there. So this is just like an interesting little surprise cupcake behind the flap there. There, thank you.
Gorgeous. Right then, I'm going to just do a final recap. Thank you, Sue. We'll have a wave from you right at the end. Okay, let's have a look. 54 absolutely stunning hand lettered stamps. They are gorgeous. They're a really nice size because you've got those nice focal points, aren't they? And the font is just absolutely exquisite. We've got your day. And then there's the little cup and saucer there. I like that, your day, your way. It's very nice, isn't it? And then you've got a happy birthday, or I might need to lift it up a little bit. There you go, there's the cake and the birthday wishes. I bet there's been lots of cake eaten today as well. Then we've got the other top one. I'll just lift this up again, just so you'll be able to see the very bottom. Just for you, wish big, best wishes in two different fonts. Then we've got the birthday happiness. And then down to the bottom, there we go. We've got I like the be brave, be good, stay you, happy birthday, birthday wishes, and then I love the positive vibes one. Positive vibes only, that's what we want. And then next one in the middle, we've got the have the best day today and that nice champagne cork. There's also a flute of champagne. And then you've got the celebrate, lovely little hearts and swirls. And what's that one? Today is the day. And then you've got the happy. And then there's some bunting, which, as I said, very apt for today. And our final one, you've got this. Like it, you've got this. And then there's a hello, little letter, and you've got the dream big and happy birthday to you. And just to finish off then, I have a few more samples. This one is by Jackie. Lovely, just a really nice inky background, and then it just really stands out with the black. This is using all the little worker stamps. This one's also by Jackie. And then we've got this one with the birthday wishes. That's gorgeous, isn't it? And all those candles, marvellous. We've got some planner pages. Hang on, got lots here. And you can see with some photos, we've got the, what do you call it? For champagne flute, we couldn't think of the word. There's the celebrate. Ah, that's really nice. There's a dream big. This is fabulous, all these pages. Happy wish. Positive, best, good. Nice. Right, you can spread the cost. Two payments of £29.98. 332875 is the item number. And then Sue, do you want to just give us a little wave then? Thank you so much for coming in, Sue.
It's a great pleasure. Thanks for having me.
having me.
Bless. Yes, all good. Thank you very much for keeping me company, and I want you to keep me company in the next hour, that's for sure. Don't go anywhere.